Today, we are exploring open valleys and foothills to learn about the diagnostic characteristics of four genera in the Themidaceae, a family that has undergone recent taxonomic changes. The Themidaceae is a Western North American family of geophytic perennial herbs that are closely related to the hyacinth and agave families. Members of the Themidaceae are monocots. They have three sepals and three petals that look similar. The six perianth parts are petal-like in color and texture. The plants have thin, basal leaves that generally do not persist. The stems and leaves arise from short underground stems that persist between growing seasons as storage organs, called corms. The inflorescences are umbels, that is, the flower stalks or pedicels radiate from a common point of attachment. Although they look superficially similar to the genus Allium, members of the Themidaceae do not have an onion-like smell. To tell apart some of the commonly encountered genera of the Themidaceae, we first look at the perianth parts. Are they free or fused at the base? All of the species pictured here have fused perianth parts that form an obvious tube. If the perianth parts are partially fused, the next character to look for is the number of fertile stamens. Are there three or six? This is the easiest way to identify two genera in the Themidaceae, Brodiaea and Dichelostemma. The perianth parts are fused at the base and they have three fertile stamens. Once you've seen three stamens and narrowed down the possible identity of these plants to either Brodiaea or Dichelostemma, it's time to look inside the flower. Are there sterile stamens called staminodes in between the stamens as seen here in Brodiaea elegans? The presence of these staminodes is characteristic of most members of the genus Brodiaea. Or are the staminodes absent, as in Dichelostemma congestum and most other species in the genus Dichelostemma? Now that we've learned how to look for staminodes to distinguish Brodiaea and Dichelostemma, we can learn how to identify two of the common genera in this family that have six anthers: Dipterostemon and Triteleia. Dipterostemon has only one species, which is widespread, Dipterostemon capitatus. Some of our viewers might remember these plants being called Dichelostemma capitatum, but the taxonomic treatment now presented in the Jepson eFlora reflects a new understanding that this species does not belong in Dichelostemma based on its evolutionary relationships. Inside the flowers of Dipterostemon capitatus, we see six stamens with filaments that each attach to the base of an anther. Triteleia, the last genus featured in this video, has 14 species in California and is especially diverse in central and northern regions of the state. Inside the flowers, we see six stamens with filaments that each attach to the middle of an anther. Members of Triteleia vary in distributional range from widespread and common, such as Triteleia ixioides and Triteleia laxa, to narrowly endemic and rare, such as Triteleia piutensis. Although these genera may look similar at first glance, looking at them more closely, as we have done here, is a revealing and rewarding way to gain more appreciation for this diverse family. Members of the Themidaceae are attractive to native plant enthusiasts and are also popular with pollinators such as bumblebees and bumblebee moths. Thanks for watching and learning more about this beautiful and diverse family of geophytes.